I'll just join the rest of the industry to cry that the NNPC would reduce contracting cycles. That's the number one cry in the industry. I mean, you talk to NNPC, you talk to JV partners, you talk to oil and gas companies, they'll tell you that it takes maybe about 2-3 years to get NNPC to finally agree and give the approval required to move on some particular projects. And that's why projects delay. It's not because the companies don't want to do it, but because the cycle is so long. So I think that should be their first focus. Reduce the contracting cycle so that a lot more projects can get done on time. The second thing I like to say is that the board should also focus on retaining and increasing the transparency in the NNPC. We have a degree of transparency. We see the NNPC's results. We see what an MPDC sort of did. We need more transparency into MPDC as well. Then we need transparency in the downstream as well. I mean, till date, and this is something that people that look at our sector always ask me from outside the country, that how much gasoline is being consumed in Nigeria? I mean, we can argue this till tomorrow. NNPC says 40 million liters, but I can tell you Nigeria does not consume 40 liters. Who is selling 40 million liters of gasoline daily in Nigeria? You know, how much is being sold by Total, Mobil? By law, all these companies should deliver a report to NNPC every week or every month so that we know who is buying what, who is selling what, who is consuming it. You know, that way we can measure the impact on the economy every time we increase prices or we reduce prices. If we work with 40 million liters, I mean, it just looks like a nice figure to work with, but we probably don't consume that much. My opinion for Nigeria's budget has always been that Nigeria should stop using budget benchmark, and instead they should start using budget benchmark contribution instead. Let's set a contribution for oil, that oil should not contribute more than 30% of budget or 40% of budget, whatever percent of revenue for budget. We need to set that benchmark so that whatever price oil is, doesn't matter. We just know that if we expect oil to be this much and it is this much, we expect oil to contribute only $800 million or 800 billion to our billion naira to our budget for this year. And the moment we hit that, every other thing above that goes into the excess cool account. We need to reduce the focus on oil. If we say we're trying to diversify and the first thing we talk about every year is this is the price of oil, this is the price, then we are not really diversifying. That's just an aside. Now, on the prices itself, is it in line with global realities? Our own forecast, because we do a forecast for oil prices every year, and I think we've been quite close. For instance, in 2015, we forecasted that oil would average 56, and it was average of 54. This year, we forecasted that it would average $40. So far, we are still on track with that one. It's still average of $40 this year. For next year, we forecasted 46 already. As well, and so there are 42. In my opinion, their $42 oil is quite close to reality, and it's still in line with market. The market expects that oil prices will actually pick up a lot more from next year. We may see more of $60 oil next year, likely more of $55-$60 oil next year, but not a lot of nothing much above $60. Not sure we'll see, except of course market is difficult to predict, because except there are circumstances that lead to major spikes, severe shortages, severe events, hurricanes that damage oil fields or refineries, we may see oil prices oscillate significantly. But I think next year is safe to expect $46 average for next year. So, and then subsequently, I mean, they've also chosen 45 and so on, and I think that's in line. But for me, the key point is we need to stop increasing the benchmark every year. The second part of the assumption is the oil production. There's an estimation that we're still going to produce 2 million barrels or thereabout next year, and there's absolutely no guarantee of that. This year, we're likely to average 1.5 million barrels per day. Next year, I expect that we're likely to average 1.8. So 2 million is really a far fetch. We have not done 2 million barrels per day in 2 years. Not as in a daily production, but as an average for the year, we have not done 2 million barrels per day for 2-3 years now even. So the question is, where is 2 million barrels going to come from? And in my opinion, they will be safer working with 1.8 for the next 2-3 years. And if we do more than that, fantastic. But working with 1.8 and your $42 per barrel is great. Nigeria is still the most attractive country when it comes to oil and gas in Africa, give or take. When it comes to resources below the ground, Nigeria is believed to still have about 600 trillion cubic feet of natural gas undiscovered yet. That's one. The number two is that we still have about 36 billion barrels of oil. Offshore Niger Delta, where we have not done much exploration, there's potentially another 22 billion barrels that we have not yet discovered as well. So there's still a lot of oil and gas that Nigeria has not touched. Why? Because we have not done any real exploration in the last 10 years. None. Number two, when it comes to resource, Nigeria's problems are all above ground. The problem is not beneath ground. If you go to any other country in Africa, you're still trying to be sure that there's actually oil in the ground. Nigeria, there's every certainty you need that there's oil in the ground. You know, there's every proof. So investors like Nigeria, they like the fact that where Nigeria is also positioned, Nigeria could potentially serve the whole of West and Southern Africa in terms of the coastline, in terms of supply of petroleum products. And that's something Dangote is trying to quickly key into, because where he has positioned his refinery, it makes it easy for him to ship out his petroleum products to anywhere else in the Africa. So I think in terms of, are investors happy to invest in Nigeria? I'd say yes, they like Nigeria, but the circumstances around our economy, around our policies for FX and business, that's what's still delaying investments. So the IOCs, for instance, they postponed a lot of projects that were meant to be 2016, 2017 into 2018, 2019, 2020, because they want the situation to improve before they make those investments. So I think we'll see investments, but it may not be as early as we think. It may be in later years.